The first significant project that Sammy and I worked on was an electric scooter.
Our fraternity was on the other side of the Charles from MIT's campus, which means we had to go across the Harvard Bridge. We very quickly learned we were better mechanical engineers than we were electrical engineers because it didn't really have enough power to go up the hill.
We really enjoyed working on projects together more than anything else.
Both him and I would joke and kind of dream about, you know, 20 years from now being founders of this very large company that's doing all kinds of advanced research into different scientific areas and crazy engineering endeavors. And that really was like the seed that we would eventually start a company together.
We are making a miniature humanoid robot that essentially is an avatar for the surgeon. It replicates the full upper body motion of the surgeon. And it's designed to be able to go in through a single 15 millimeter incision. It would enable surgeons to do laparoscopic procedures with less injury to the patient and more capability for the surgeon.
Current generation surgical robotic systems try to roboticize laparoscopy directly. We took a step back and said, how would we perform minimally invasive surgery if we were starting from scratch today? The ideal form is to miniaturize yourself, go through that little small incision and go inside the patient.
The entire goal of this is to provide the surgeon with incredible dexterity and the ability to perform operations across the entire abdominal cavity, all through one incision placed anywhere in the abdomen.
The key differentiating technology that we've developed over the years is something we refer to as decoupled actuators. When I move the wrist, I don't want the elbow or the shoulder of the robot to move. I want it to do exactly what I want and only what I want. Doing that actually creates a robot that's easier to control both for the user as well as for the computer itself that's actually driving the robot. It allows for more degrees of freedom of the robot. You have access to the entire abdomen like no other system out there.
It's gonna be a very long time till we see operating rooms without surgeons at all. The future that we're aiming to build, it's one where surgeons are no longer doing the primary core of the operation by themselves manually.
If my college self was looking at where I am today, they wouldn't have expected, I think, that little idea we had, you know, 12 years ago to be where it is today. MIT really helped me learn how to think, how to ask questions, how to work on a team, how to pursue my passion for building things.
The group of people that you're surrounded with is incredible and really inspirational at MIT. And that to me is what, you know, inspired and directly helped push us to start this company and develop the technology.